file and set up on Oracle VirtualBox. Looking at the description, was designed by Sachin Verma, and it says the box is quite straightforward, but we have to be aware of the rabbit holes. The difficulty for this box from the author is given as intermediate. At the end of this live stream, I will give you if it is really intermediate or if it's more or less than that. And here's a file information just to make sure that you haven't downloaded a broken box. And the DNCP is enabled. Here are some of the screenshots. Being said that, if you are new to this channel or if you haven't subscribed to the channel, make sure you do that so that you are notified when a new videos are published. Now let's go up, and I will copy this particular name so that I can create a directory here. Go to root, go to VulnHub directory, make a particular directory. Let's get into that. And I'm going to use tmux so that I can split my screen. So in the pentest assessment, the first thing is to identify the target. Currently we know the particular target. It is 192.168.56.56.119. just in case you don't know the target IP, you can go for ping, sweep, nmap or any kind of enumeration to identify the vulnerable port. So for now, we'll directly start with the nmap enumeration. I'm going for a full port scan, since it's in a local network, it will be pretty fast. And it's okay, and go for hyphen v. So here hyphen p is for all port scan, hyphen sc for default script, and hyphen sv for version enumeration. It would take some time, not more than a second, or I think not more than a minute. So let's wait for this to be completed. And I think we have already seen there is a port 8080 open, there is a MySQL port 3306, there is SSH port, there is HTTP, and there is an unusual port. Let me scroll that up. So here we have 3306 from, I'm not sure what is MySQL X, most probably it's a secure version of MySQL. And on port 80 we have CMS made simple, port 22 it's SSH, but it's 7.9. In previous version of SSH below 7.2, there was a vulnerability called user enumeration, from where we can identify the user that we're trying is on the box or not. So for now, let's go for port 80. The box, go for 192.119. It's posted, and it's, the title is home my school, and it's made up of simple CMS made simple. So let me search if there is any vulnerability regarding to this CMS or not. Let's go back to another pane. I'm using search exploit to find that. Now if you can see, there are many vulnerabilities related to CMS made simple. The problem here is this CMS version is 2.2.14, but when looking at all the results, I don't see anything vulnerable to that. So we can play around this tool, click on here and there and play around this tool, but we don't get anything. It's a kind of a rabbit hole. So quickly we'll stop that and go for port 8080. So on port 8080, it's a newly not set up WordPress, and here it says some kind of information. So let's remove that. What do I get? And it's asked for the let me open it in a private browser. Let's enter, and it's asking for the site title. So what I have done previously is you won't get this until and unless we have the page where we need to specify the database user and credentials. So what I have done previously is I have started a MySQL service on my local host, MySQL status, and I've already created a database called hyphen u for root, hyphen p nothing. this is, and spelling out databases, press enter, and here I've already created this particular database and also created a new user called my user along with the password, and I'm hosting this MySQL on my all the networks so that it is reachable to this victim machine. For now, let's give as test username, give as admin, scope for admin, confirm user with password, email address I'm not required. So now let's click on install WordPress. So it's asking for a valid email. So let's go for gmail.com, confirm user password, admin, and it has successfully installed. Now let's click on login. Since we already know the password, go for admin. You could have set any password you want. Now to get a reverse shell, I'm going to the theme editor. Okay, I click back, theme editor, yes I understand. And let's look for something called as header. There's footer, there's index. Let's go for 404. So 404, here I'm going to just print my php info so that we confirm we are able to execute any of the code. php info, close it, and here we need to give php as well. So update this file, go to the home directory, and let's go for any random thing. So one, as soon as I give 404 any path, so it is able to print php info. So for now let's get a reverse shell. Exit it from here, locate php reverse, and let's use this one, copy. I'm going to copy in my local directory, and now let's change this file to reflect our attacker's machine. So port number 8888, I don't have any issues with that, and my local IP is 192.168.56.107. let's paste it, cat php reverse shell. I'm going to copy it using escalate, and it's copied. Let's go back here and remove the entire thing, paste it, and update the file. Before that, now before I go and refresh the page, let me set up a litcat listener and edit it. Go back to this browser, and once I press enter, if you can see on the left hand side, I've already got the shell. Who am I? I'm wdata. Now since it was a WordPress file, my first step is to go and check for the wconfig file. So wconfig file is in var www.html. press ls enter. There is a directory called WordPress. Let's get into that. Press ls, and I'm going to see what's inside with wp-config, and this is what I am intended to see. So let's go for cat, and if I scroll up, most probably I can see the username and password. So here I don't have anything. I need to look somewhere else where I can find the username and password for this. And so this is one that we created. Instead of that, let's roll back to var www and html. Now if we remember correctly, there was also another application called cms, made simple, running on port 80. I'm going to see what configurations do we have here. For that, let's go to the Kali machine, go to cmsms, press ls, and here we have this config file. Let's look inside, what do we have here. So paste it, and here we have the database connection. So it says root, and we have the password. Let me copy this password and escalate. Before that, why don't I save it somewhere so that it is easy for me to copy and paste moving forward. So new test, paste the password. Let me zoom it a bit. Before that, I need to update my shell. So let's search for Python. We do have Python, so python-c import pty, okay, pty dot spawn, go for bin bash, paste. Oh, I typed it wrong. So now let's go for import pty, pty dot spawn spawn, bin bash. Now we upgraded our shell. Now let me press Ctrl G, go for stty raw echo fg, and I broke something. Yes, I did. Oh god, I think I need to restart the whole process right now. It won't take much time, so again let's refresh it, go back to terminal. Here for one, it was on port 8888. Let's refresh it, and I've got a shell. Go to new terminal, and I think I should go for pass rather than zsh. So here for lnvp 8888. Let me close this quickly. Browser, enter, pass, we have got that. So python-c import pty, pty dot spawn, go for bin bash, press enter, control z, pty raw hyphen echo fg. Clear is not there, so let's go for export equals to xterm. Now clear, now everything is good. We have already captured the password for root, so let's copy that and sudo for root, paste the password, and it didn't work. So most probably it's might be password for some other user, and if I go to home, I can see there is a user armorer. So let's go for that, sudo armour, paste the password, and I have become that user. So this is a lateral movement, and from here let's go for sudo hyphen l, and we can see there is a sudo binary called rclone, and it is able to allow run any of this command as a root user. So using this, let's search for gtfo bin. GTFO bin GitHub, search for that, and unfortunately we don't have anything. So do we have man for our clone? We don't have. What about on my main system? There is no entry for our clone. So I think we can do a bit of research, or go for sudo, paste it. And what does it do? So port about authorized cat concatenate any files, send them to std out. I'm not interested in that. Copy files from source to destination, skipping already copied files, copy to, and we have delete. And tree mkdir purge. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to edit etc password using this sudo writes. So let's copy etc password to temp, go to temp and edit etc password. And before that, let's create a password using OpenSSL. So OpenSSL password for user, and here we have got the password for user. And what I'm going to do is, let's go for fz. Let's try to make something similar here, but instead of that, there will be user colon 0 colon 0 colon root, and here's the directory root, and go for bin bash, almost similar, but here instead of x I'm going to paste the password. So control s x and sudo, what was that, sudo hyphen l. I'm going to use this, copy sudo hyphen l, copy c, copy temp password to etc password, and sudo hyphen l, I need to give this copy, and it says it has copied. Now let's look at the content of etc password. Etc password, scroll a bit, and I don't see any of those. Have I made the changes? And yes, I have done that. Yeah, I have done that correctly. So before that, let's delete etc password. So delete etc password. What about now? Cat etc. Okay, and I cannot do that. So instead of going this forward, how can I get that? So now I guess something wrong. So copy or clone copy temp password to etc. etc clear more etc password, and I don't think worked. Okay. So we have root. And we have etc password. So why don't I again go for sudo r clone, says tree cat, or I can quickly send him to a study out. What about this, sudo r clone cat etc shadow, and I can see password for that. Also I do have the password for root, it's a hash, and I can crack it. But instead my plan is simple, and I just want to change the etc password so that I can escalate my privilege. So there are different ways anyone can be used, and so it's not working. Sudo r clone copy from temp password to etc and more etc password, and I think it has successfully copied. Most probably it was because of this. So I was giving this, and to which it was not able to recognize the directory. But since I've already copied that, let's go for sudo user. The password was user, and I have become root. Let's go to the root folder, ls cat proof.txt, and here we have got our flag as well. So this was our last flag, what about the normal user flag? So ls the directory cat user. So we could have seen the user.txt and moved to root.txt, but I came way around. And that's it from the live stream.
Thank you for watching this video. If you learned something new today, please give a thumbs up and share it with your friends. For any doubts, suggestion or advice, kindly post it into the comment section. I will make sure to reply to the comments. Also, do not forget to subscribe to the channel. This will encourage me to contribute more to InfoSec and cybersecurity community.